Hello everyone, welcome to the current affairs session of Neo IAS. So today we'll be dealing with a personality called Jamshedji Tata. First of all, let's see why this personality is in news. So it is the 182nd birth anniversary of Jamshedji Tata, hailed as the original Make in India man. So let's see more about this personality. Jamshedji Nuzirwanji Tata was an Indian pioneer industrialist and he founded the Tata Group, the India's biggest conglomerate company. Jamshedji Tata is regarded as the legendary father of Indian industry. He was so influential that the Jawaharlal Nehru referred to him as a one-man planning commission. Jamshedji Tata believed in the Swadeshi principle, that is encouraging the domestic goods and the boycott of foreign imports. Because of this reason itself, he named his new cotton mill in Bombay, Bombay, as Swadeshi mill, and the original idea for this new mill was to produce a finer cloth just like the one from Manchester. So at that time the cloth that was made in India was much more coarse. Because of that reason there were no much demand for the Indian cloth, but Tata wanted to change this. He wanted the Indian clothes to have much more market. He wanted them to have demand. For that reason he established the Swadeshi mill, which aimed to produce finer clothes. Jamshedji Tata believed that the economic empowerment of India can be sustained only if India acquired the scientific and technological prowess to support this progress. So he believed that if India want to grow, or if India want to become a developed country, or if India want to grow, then it will have to achieve more and more scientific and technological advancement. And this Jamshedji Tata had four major goals in his life that he wanted to achieve within his lifetime itself, which were setting up an iron and steel company, a world-class learning institution, a unique hotel, and a hydroelectric plant. So the only aim he was able to realize within his lifetime was setting up a unique hotel, which became a reality by the inauguration of Taj Mahal Hotel in Mumbai in 1903. And at the time this was the only hotel in India to have electricity. Successors of Jamshedji Tata's, their works were able to achieve the remaining three ideas, and the first among them was a iron and steel company. So that is the Tata Steel Limited, which is formerly called as the TISCO, the Tata Iron and Steel Company. So at the time of establishment, TISCO was Asia's first and India's largest steel company, and the TISCO was established in Jamshedpur in 1907. So Jamshedpur city was originally a village which was called Sakchi, and it was renamed into Jamshedpur by the then Viceroy of India, Chelmsford. So the then Viceroy of India, Chelmsford, renamed Jamshedpur, the Sakchi village, into Jamshedpur city as an honor to Jamshedji Tata. And this city, Jamshedpur, recently completed 100 years. Also, Jamshedji Tata's aim or goal of establishing a world-class learning institution was realized by the establishment of Indian Institute of Science in Bangalore. And this is the preeminent Indian institution for research and education in science as well as engineering. So this has played a role in helping create several national institutions, that is by providing the intellectual framework for institutions like the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, the Indian Space Research Organization, etc. Through its distinguished alumni. And Tata's another goal of establishing or building a hydroelectric power plant was established by the creation or the establishment of Tata Hydroelectric Power Supply Company, which was later renamed into Tata Power Company Limited. And currently, this company is India's largest private electricity company. He also provided scholarship schemes for higher education from 1892. This was the time when changes in rules made it increasingly difficult for the Indians to apply in the civil services. So at that time, he loaned such kind of a scholarship scheme, and that equipped or that helped many Indians to succeed and become civil servants. So an interesting fact along with this is that by the 1920s, one in five Indians in Indian civil services was a Jayan Tata scholar. And the scholarship that he provided was never a grant, but it always was a loan, because he wanted these people to, or these students to repay this amount once they reach a position. The reason for this was that he believed that self-respect and self-esteem were essential building blocks of the self-reliance. For that reason, he provided loans and never grants. So, that's all about today's personality. Thank you.